The Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II, which is a single-seat, single-engine, all-weather stealth multi-role fighter, is undergoing final development and testing by the United States. The Pentagon began the F-35 program in 2001 with an aim to develop a cost-effective replacement for the U.S. military's F-15, F-16, and F-18 fighters and reconnaissance aircraft, as well as A-10 close air support warplanes. Apart from the United States, the primary customer and financial backer, the United Kingdom, Italy, the Netherlands, Canada, Turkey, Australia, Norway, and Denmark are also part of the program. Many other nations like Japan and Israel are also deploying the fighters. S-400 Triumph is an anti-aircraft weapon system developed by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau in the 1990s as an upgrade of the S-300 family. It's been in service with the Russian Armed Forces since 2007. It's designed to defend against aircraft including 5th-generation stealth fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and ballistic missiles. It's considered one of the most powerful anti-aircraft defense systems in the world. In a conflict between NATO and Russia, these two systems will surely come face to face. The outcome of their encounter will have a huge impact on who will have the upper hand. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Russian S-400 could compromise F-35 program without even firing a shot. Let's get into the details. Turkey has more than 100 F-35s on order. It has already received 2 F-35s. Not only this, being one of the major partners, it's responsible for the production of certain components of the F-35 and will also provide maintenance support to other European customers of the jet. It's to be noted that Turkey is not only an important player in the F-35 program, but it's also an important NATO member. In July 2017, Turkey reportedly signed the deal to acquire the S-400 air defense system from Russia. Turkey has insisted that since it currently has Cold War-era surface-to-air missile system, it requires an upgrade and S-400 fits in perfectly. The United States, NATO nations, and members of the Joint Strike Fighter program are all concerned that S-400 will be able to gather technical data such as radar signature of F-35s if Turkey operates the jets in the airspace which is monitored by S-400. This could potentially pass onto Russian hands and give them an unprecedented advantage in future conflicts. Furthermore, in an integrated air defense system setup, S-400 will be hooked to Turkish air defense. This could lead to critical compromise since the NATO defense will have profiles of F-35s already set for IFF, identification friend or foe, and through S-400, Russia could get those information. In addition, having the S-400 linked into Turkish defense networks could potentially give Russian technicians access to sensitive information that passes through the cloud-based multinational autonomic logistics information system, ALIS system of F-35s. ALIS has critical mission data and flight routes. U.S. Army General Curtis Scaparotti, the head of U.S. forces in Europe, told a Senate Armed Services Committee, "My best military advice would be that we don't then follow through with the F-35, flying it or working with an ally that's working with Russian systems, particularly air defense systems, with what I would say is probably one of the most advanced technological capabilities." NATO Allied Air Commander General Todd Walters had stated, "Anything that an S-400 can do that affords it the ability to better understand a capability like the F-35 is certainly not to the advantage of the coalition." Viewers may note that NATO is an alliance formed to counter Russia, and F-35 is geared towards penetrating Russia and Chinese air defenses. If Russia gets access to F-35s through Turkey, the F-35's capability to defeat air defense, especially S-400, will be heavily degraded. It is to be noted that Russia already dubs the S-400 as stealth killer, and there's good reason for this. The powerful main radar of S-400, which has a range of 600 kilometers, is complemented by target acquisition radars like 67N6 Gamma D and 9N6 Prativnik G radars in L band, Nebo SVU in the very high frequency band, and Nebo M and Zebu M in multiband. Nebo SVU and Zebu M is touted to have the ability to detect stealth aircraft. Also, it's to be taken into deliberation that though F-35 is a stealthy fighter, it has many compromises, unlike the F-22 Raptor. F-35's airframe is not as stealthy as one on the F-22 Raptor. Against X-band radars, it's only stealthy from the front and rear. Against S-band radar, it's stealthy from the narrow front aspect. Against L-band radar, the limited reduction is achieved from direct front. It has a much greater reliance on radar-absorbing materials to maintain its stealth profile. Taking everything into consideration, it's safe to assume that if Russia gets hands on classified technical data of F-35s, then it will be able to tune S-400 in a much better way to detect it.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.